Okay, so this looks like y equals mx plus b. There we go. Which means we know the graph is going to be a what?
Linear.
It's going to be a line. It's going to have a slope, constant slope, a slope that doesn't change, right? If your graph is anything but a line, it still has slopes, but those slopes are always changing, right? The slope of this is always changing. So it's a line, we need 2 points, so we find the easiest point, the easiest point is?
Zero.
Zero, comma?
Negative 3.
Zero, comma, -3. That point we call?
The y-intercept.
The y-intercept. An abbreviation of y-intercept. Okay, we could plug in 1, we could plug in 2. All these things, though, if we plug them in for x, are going to give us fractions. So we jump all the way to a number that doesn't give us a fraction when we multiply it by 5/8, and that number is what?
8/1.
Or we could jump to 16. We could jump to 4. 2,
8,
64, anything that's a multiple of 8. But 8, why not use the smallest one? So we get 5/8 times 8, that's going to be 5 minus 3, right? Is what?
2.
So we go over to 8, comma 2, which is the same as if we just went to the right 8 and
up 2.
Up 2.
Up 5.
5, right? Over 8 and up 5. Over 8 and up 5. Well, I could go another 8 and go up another 5, but I'll just have found another point that's part of that line, and I'll then work the necessary. Draw ourselves a nice little line. So we go to our y-intercept, and we can follow our slope to that point. Y equals -3 plus x plus 6. Let's graph that real quick. It should take maybe a minute, if that much. Maybe 30 seconds. Maybe the time I put this over here. Maybe not that fast. Okay, the easiest point we can find is?
Zero.
Zero for x and 6 for y. Let's see it. If we plug 0 in there, we get nothing plus 6 and it is 6. So 0, 6. Okay. We'll skip past 1 and 2 and 3, go straight to 4. And when we put a 4 in there, 4 divides 4, 4 divides 4, and gives us a 1. -3 plus that 6, which is what?
Excuse me.
3. So you get 4/3, which I'll go ahead and put this point here. It's the same as if we had gone over 4, and we know that that's going to make us go down 3 from where we were, which was at 6. We go down 3. There we could go. Over another 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, go down another 3, and there we are. Which tells me that if I were to plug in an 8 into the equation, what should I get for y according to this point? 8, 3 lower than 3,
11.
Where's that?
It's on the six axis.
Six axis.
Sorry, not six axis.
X axis.
Yeah, x axis.
And it's at
six.
No.
Are
you?
Well, no, actually, just like
notice
something.
Uh huh.
You can actually go. Okay. Okay. So you see all the little tiny dots.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you go to like the main dot, the 6.
This one.
And then you follow it diagonally.
True.
I don't know, I was just like sitting there just staring at those.
Yeah, because now if we were to go down like diagonally, perfect diagonally like that, then that would be a different line. It would have a slope of down 1 and over 1, so it'd be a slope of down 1. This guy here is almost negative 1, right? It's almost negative 1, so yeah, it's just a little bit off of a perfect diagonal like that. And since the pattern is, we can move over 4 and down 3, over 4 and down 3, it's also going to follow that pattern to diagonal 3 and over 1. So, yes. True. And then we can draw our line. When I draw that line, what am I really drawing? All those little dots. How many is all those little dots?
Infinity.
An infinite number of points. I'm guessing where all those other points are going to land. If I were to move over, I go down 3/4, and that certainly looks accurate. Right? Now we get 6 minus 3/4. We get 5 and 4. So, just a quick recap. Let's see. We also talked about, no, we didn't talk about that. So let's talk about a different form of linear equation. Let's make it 12. Okay. So 2x plus 3y equals 12. Let's first talk about how we could just graph it in this form, right? It's about finding two easy points, okay? So in this previous one, how did we find the first easiest point?
Zero.
Zero for x, let's try it again, zero for x. So if I put zero in there, I'll get nothing, plus 3y equals 12, and 3y equals 12, plus nothing, divided by 3, and y equals 4. That wasn't too hard.
Last year, didn't we do these?
Probably.
Like, that seemed really familiar.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, we did.
So then you maybe remember just the way this equation is set up, how we could easily find another point?
Can't you just do it backwards?
Yeah.
What do you mean backwards?
Do 3, you put 0 for 5.
No, you do.
For y, I put for 0 for y, yeah.
You do
just that. Right. Now putting something in for y here is a little bit like, I'm not sure if that's going to work out very nicely.
Right.
Right. But for this one, the way it's set up, I just know it's going to cancel out that term, and all I have to do is
2
by 2.
Right?
2x equals 12 divided by 2, we get
6.
So there we go. Yeah, good. This is what we call standard form. Right. That was a good strategy for finding points on this line if it's set up this way. So we plug in 0 for x and 0 for y, we got 2 points, and we can move on from there. 4 and 6, 0. 6, 0, and we have ourselves 2 points. And we can draw the line through those 2 points.
I like your stretching.
But we could also take this equation, 2x plus 3y, and rewrite it like this, so that it looks like this. Okay. So what would we have to do to this equation to get it to look like this equation?
We have to move the x over to 12 side.
So we're going
to
get where?
We have to carry it over.
So we're getting the y by itself, right? So how do we get this 2x out of here?
3y equals negative 2x plus 12.
Okay, so subtract 2x from both sides.
Yeah.
And we get 3y equals negative 2x plus 12. And?
And then you do another one.
Well, how do we get y by itself? It's almost by itself.
Divide by 3.
Divide by 3 on both sides. Divide by 3. Here, y equals negative 2/3 x plus, what's the 4? Okay, well, let's see. That if I were to graph this, I would put in 0 for x again and get 4. Okay, indeed, that worked. All right. And then I would follow my slip and go over two and down three, so I'd go, so I go over three and down two. So I go over three, down two, so I go over three again and down two again, and here I am at this point here. So I can graph it, like all of this would be called graphing in standard form. The strategy there is let's let x be zero, let y be zero, x be zero and y be zero, standard form. This would be called rewriting. And what is this form called again? We're concentrating on the slope and the y-intercept.
Slope-intercept.
So we call it slope-intercept.
I always just got slope in my head. I don't know why. It's always slope.
Well, that is the slope of the line, right? It's got a slope of down 2 into the right 3, down 2, right 3, down 2, right 3, or the right 3, down 2, whatever. Or to the left 3 and up 2. You got a negative change, positive change. Okay. So we can graph in standard form by letting x and y both be 0 and getting 2 points. We can rewrite it and put it in slope-intercept form and graph it that way, right? There's our y-intercept and there's our slope, and put our point there, follow our slope. Okay. Now let's see. I'm gonna leave you to this for a minute or two. If there is a point at 3, 4, and at 8, 12, okay, what's the All right, did we figure out what the slope of this line was?
Yep.
What was it?
8 minutes.
8. Yeah, so how did you come up with that?
12 minus 4.
12 minus 4.
Over. 8 minus 3.
All right, that's correct. 8 over 5. Now, if we were to look at the graph, okay, we could just confirm that this is correct. So we've got the 3, 4, there it is, and we've got 8, 12, there's 8, and we go all the way up to 12, which is about there. If we were to look at the slope of this line, the change in y or the change in x, we go up 8 and to the right 5. We have a slope of 8, that's correct. Let's try 5, 7 and a point at 11, negative 4. All right, what slope did we find for the line between these two points?
Negative 4.
Just negative 4?
Minus 7.
Okay, I see. You're telling me how to find it. Negative 4 minus 7 over
11.
11 minus 5. Okay. So what you've done here, you called this point number 2, okay, which means that this x is the x2 and this is the y2. And you call this essentially point number 1, and this is the x1 and the y. 1, right? So you take y2, negative 4, minus y1, which is 7. You come back to point 2, take the 11, subtract 5, that's the x1, so that's y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So negative 4 minus 7 is negative 11. And 11 minus 5 is 6. Negative 11, 6. So if we were to draw these two points, down 11 over 6, and find another point. And if we were to just think about these two points, we know that we would have a negative slope because we know we would have a decrease in y. 7. And then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. we know that we would have a negative slope, and we're back again, negative 11, 6, slope down 11, to the right 6. Can we write the equation of this? Plus or minus something, right? We can just say plus b, whatever that is. It can be figured out from there. How?
You know that the slope is 11, negative 11x.
Negative 11x?
Negative 11 over 6.
Right.
X.
The slope is just negative 11 over 6. Boom. That's the slope.
Yes.
Not 11 over 6, x. That's not the slope.
Right.
Right. Okay. So the slope is right there, negative 11, 6. That's why we're going to put it in there, right? Because that's the slope. Right? So what can we do from here? How do we move on from here? We need b, right? If we knew what b, if I just could say plus 12, then I would be done. Agreed?
Oh, I'm going to have to find one. Oh, I know. We're going to have to find what b is, aren't
we? We need to figure out what b is. Now we need to how do we do that? How can we figure out what b is?
I remember how we do this. Sure. I can't remember. I think it's something like you switch y and x, or I might be thinking of something else.
You're thinking of something else.
Because we get close. Because I remember when we were doing this, we try to set up the thing to what you do to find b. We had to do this long thing all the time. I can't know what it's called.
Well, there's a couple different ways, and this is the first of the two ways. Lots of ways, but two main ways I would say. Think about the way these functions work. I mean, you tell me, how does this function work? How does it function? How do you use it?
X.
Yeah.
You get rid of it, or you add to it, I guess, depending on what X is.
Right.
Zero, and then you just add 6 to it, or b, I guess you could say.
So you plug in something for x,
yeah.
Do the math, put it maybe oversimplified, do the math, and then that's what y is. Okay? Do you see one example of this is x and this is y? For this x, you get this y on this page here? See any other pairs of x's and y's that can be used in this equation, or that we put in an x and got out a certain y value?
4 and 3.
4 and 3, we plugged in 4, there's the work there. 4, 4 cancels, you get a negative 3 plus 6 is 3, so we got 4, 3. What's going
to
happen if I put a 4 here and a 3 here? Put a 4 right there and a 3 right there.
3 plus y, I think it was something like 3 plus y, and then it's negative 3 fourths minus plus 4 plus x, 4x, sorry, isn't it something like that?
Well, if I replace this y with a 3, if I replace this y with a 3, and this x over here with a 4, what I'm trying to get at is, get an equation that's true, right? We'll get a 3 equals, we already did this, right? Right here. What do we get? 3, right? It's true, it works. That's what this function's looking for. It's looking for an x and y that make both sides equal. Right, and there's an example. Let's go back to the problem we just had.
I remember now, for our so we got rid of the y, we just did like plus 3 y or something like that. We just had y always be.
Y always be nothing or 1, but I don't know.
It's like, because for multiplication, you always just say y is 1 and it's by itself. But if you're like adding to it, it's just kind of 0. It was just y wasn't representing anything.
Well, you could say
just how we
1
did
times
it.
Y?
Yeah, we did it like that.
Well, notice, like, what we have here is a, we have an x and a y. Here's another x and a y. Let's say I were to plug 5 in for this x, and we have 11 times 6 times 5 plus b. Don't you know what this would come out to be? If I plugged in 5 for x?
7 should come out.
7 should come out. Why? Because I was told that that's a point on the line. So I should be able to plug in 5 for x and get 7 for y. And what's the only variable left?
B.
B. Can we get b by itself? So 7 equals negative 11 6 times 5 over 1, so it's a negative 55 over 6 plus b. Okay. How do we get b by itself?
You gotta distribute the 7 to the. I don't know how to explain this. I know what to do, but I don't know how you explain it.
Just try to solve for b. We got negative 55 sixths plus b. I don't want this negative 55 sixths on the side of b. What can I do to cancel out the negative 55
sixths? Over to the, like, you distribute to the right, I mean to the left, sorry. So it'd be like.
What we're really going to do is cancel it on this side, and then whatever it takes to cancel it, we do the exact same thing over here.
Yeah, right? So it'd be like, that. And you just
55 sixths, so then we have 7 plus 55 6, that's b. Once we figure out what this is. So we'll have to do 42 over 6, right? Get a common denominator. And that gives us 97 over 6, and that's what b is. Right. Remember, just a few steps ago, we were saying if we knew what b was, we just put it in, there we'd be done. We'd have the equation on the line. And now what do we have? 97 over 6?
Yeah, sorry.
Is b.
Keep saying that.
So y equals negative 11 sixths x plus 97 over 6. Okay, so that's the equation of the line that goes through these two points. Let's do it again, but let's do it with a couple of points that work out more nicely. Let's see, we'll make it 4. First, we're going to find that slope, and then find b. If you can.
Positive times the negative is positive, right?
No.
All right. Thank you.
Okay, so first we find the slope, and how do we do that? And what slope do we find?
3 minus 9. 3 minus 9.
So you're kind of calling this one point number 2.
Yeah.
Which means this is x2 and this is y2.
So that's what I'm going to
do. So this is x1 and this is y1. So we're going to do y2 minus y1. I'm only going over this so much because a common mistake here is to switch. Like, to do y2 minus y1, but in the denominator you wind up doing x1 minus x2. So you're just very careful. This is from one point, this is from another point. So 4 minus 9, you say, over. Minus 9, it should be, if we're going to minus 9, it should be 3.
Yeah, 3 minus
9. There we go. 3 minus 9.
That is 4 minus 2.
4 minus 2. 3 minus 9, 4 minus 2.
3, simplify it.
Well, let's see, we get negative 3 over 1.
Oh.
Negative.
Yeah. And then you do y.
Hold on. 4 minus 2 is.
Oh yeah, sorry, 6. Then you get 3. I was saying if you simplify it, you get 3.
This part.
Oh, wait, yeah. So, yeah.
3 minus 9 is negative 6.
Yeah. You still get
it. Oh.
Yeah. Threw me off there. Confused me.
Yeah. Well, no. Trying to be on your toes here. Negative 6 over 2 is negative 3. Yes, you have it. You have it. Okay. So that's the slope. We have y equals mx plus b. Y equals, there's the slope. Just missing b, and how can we find b?
3x times, I think it was 4.
So you're going to use this point right here. So y equals negative 3 times 4, but 3 is. Or y is 3. Okay, go ahead. Continue. Sorry.
And then you get 3 equals negative 12 plus b. And then you carry, you
add 12 and add 12. So b is 15. So our final answer, our equation is what? Slope by using y plus 1 over x2 minus x1. We then plug that into the equation y equals mx plus b, plug in an x and a y, solve for b, and there we had it. It's done. Okay.
So much space in my paper.
Maybe less now. Let's see.
Let's just bring it out.
From 10 comma 5, now times 10 comma negative 5, and negative 5 comma 1. Okay, so I'm going to show you, we're going to go again through this strategy of finding the equation of the line, and then I'm going to show you to take the exact same information and find the equation in a different way. And we're going to talk about a different form of linear equations. We're talking about slope-intercept, we've talked about standard, and then we'll talk about some point slope more. Alright. So, what first?
You gotta find the slope.
You gotta find the slope. Let's do it.
I took 1 minus negative 5.
I like that we kind of need to subtract by a negative, okay? Make sure that we're keeping that straight. So 1 minus negative 5, y2 minus y. All right, go ahead, continue.
Over negative 5 minus 10.
Negative 5 minus 10, that's just x2 minus x1. And so we have 1, what's minus negative 5 mean again?
That's, you just add it,
you just add 5, so it's 6. So now we know the slope, and we, as we try to build this equation, we have one really important piece, the slope, -2/5 x plus b. Now all we need is b. If we knew b, we just plug in b and we would be done. But we don't, so what do we do?
So you have to plug in one of those coordinates for
one of them. Either one of them, right? This one or this one. They should both work. Otherwise, we did our math wrong here on the slope. All right, so they both work. Either one work. So which one should we use?
I use point number two.
Point number two, this guy here.
Yeah.
Okay, so y is 1. There's our -2/5. X is -5. And plus b, the thing we're finding, -2/5 times -5/1, well, the 5 divided by 5 is now, so we'll put a -1 there, -5 divided by 5, -1. And now -2 times -1.
That's a positive
2. Subtract 2 from both sides. B is
-1.
And so, Our equation is y equals -2/5 x. And what was b?
-2. So it's -2.
-1.
Yeah,
oh, it's barely showing there. B is -1, so it's a plus a -1 or a -1. So y equals -2/5 x.
I don't know this now.
Good. So, now we've got this other form. We have the standard form. We could write all sorts of different forms, name them all sorts of different things. Okay? But a few of them are kind of useful. Okay? What we have here, let me just really quick take this equation. Erase this m, write it again. M equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. I'm going to multiply both sides by x2 minus x1. Multiply this side by x2 minus x1. So what I wind up with is I canceled these out, right? And so on this side I just have y2 minus y1 equals m times x2 minus x2 minus x1. Okay. Now this works for any two points, right? Any two points that are on the same line, I can subtract y2 minus y1 and x2 minus x1 and get the slope, right? And so this equation is true for any points on the line. So I can change this y to just any y minus a y from any point on the line equals m, the slope, times x, any x, okay, just the variable x, minus some x1 from a point, right, some point. And we have this thing called the point-slope form. Point-slope form. And here is the reason why it's called the point-slope form. Here is the what?
Slope.
And these two things together, x1 and y1 together, make a what?
Point.
A point.
That's what it was called.
So we have a point-slope form. Point-slope form.
Well, that's the name of it. I could remember it forever.
So if you talk to pretty much any calculus teacher, they'll say, please teach out for students the point-slope form. And it can be useful. So we'll use the point-slope form to our advantage, because here's the cool thing about it. We found the slope, right? Forget about solving for b this time. We found the slope. Here it is, -2/5. -2/5 is the slope, okay? Times x minus, we can just throw the point right into this equation. Throw the point, there's a -5 we used. -5 for x. And a 1 for y. Okay, so rewriting this a little bit. Y minus 1 equals -2/5 times x plus 5 in there. All right. And even just written this way, in the point-slope form, I can tell this is the slope. And there's a point at, since it's minus x1, this would be minus a negative 5, so that I know there's a point at negative 5, 1, because there's a minus 1 right there. I can see that what happened was I took this point slope form right here and plugged in a negative 5 to get a positive 1, and a positive 1 here to get minus 1. So that's the way it looks in the point slope form. I can also hit y by itself, and I'll have it in slope-intercept form, and I never have to solve for b. Right, first, I'll distribute this negative 2/5. I have y minus 1 equals negative 2/5 x. Negative 2/5 times 5, the 5's canceled. I'm just left with minus 2. And to solve for y, I'll add 1 to both sides. Y equals negative 2/5 x. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. That's the same as the equation we found here. So what it does there is, by rewriting the slope equation, we leave room for an x and a y to go in here with the slope, and we don't have to solve for b and then plug b back in. B just kind of comes out of solving for y. Now, on a future quest that'll be coming up, I will give you the point-slope form, and I will ask you to use the point-slope form to find the equation of a line, okay? Beyond that, you should be ready for any future math teacher to bring up the point-slope form and not be completely mystified by it. But if I ask you to find the equation of a line, it's your choice. You could use the point-slope form, which I prefer, or you could use the slope-intercept form, find the slope, plug it in, plug a point in, solve for b, plug b back into the equation, and there you go. So either way you want to go. All right. So I want you to practice using the point-slope form once. I'm going to rewrite on the next page and give you another point. Okay, so you get ready for that. You might want to write down the point-slope form in your notes, just so you can make reference to it. Okay. Points, you're going to use a point slope form. It looks like this. Y, that's the variable y, like it stays y, like the letter y throughout the entire ordeal.
Why?
Very good. Are you asking me why?
It's a math problem.
There you go. Okay, so there we go. You got the point slope form. We got 2 points. You know you need the slope, so you should find that. But then from there, you use the point slope form. Alright, so if we use the point slope form, first we gotta find the slope. So someone talk me through finding the slope.
12, well, 1
minus
negative 2.
Alright, so you're calling that y2 and that y1.
And 12 minus 6.
So x2, good, got order here. 12 minus 6.
And then that would go into 3. Over 6, also known as 1.
Also known as 1.
Alright, you can do y minus y1. No, y minus 1.
Y minus 1
equals 1 half.
Uh-huh.
X minus 12.
Okay, well that there really is an equation of a line, because it has a place that I can put input, right? And here is my output. It's usable. I can use it as an equation of a line. Can someone tell me how I would graph this equation? Graph this line? Well, we have the slope as 1/2.
Yeah. No, not the slope, but like the thing, I can't think of it.
The slope intercept form?
Yeah, so you don't refer to your back.
Yeah, sure, let's just jump it up to there and start from there.
So then it would be negative y times second.
Negative what?
Well, 1 minus 1, I mean y minus 1.
Okay, so y minus 1, and you're going to do on the right side something?
Yeah, and then what would be 12x minus, not 12, sorry, 1/2 x minus 12 with a, sorry, I'm like, I just realized I skipped like a lot of things.
Okay.
Never mind.
Well, how about we distribute the 1/2,
yeah,
right? 1/2 times x.
Because I
then
just x, but then I need to do that to the 12.
Ah, okay,
I'm just
so
trying to rush it, I guess.
Okay. But if we do distribute the 1/2 to the 12, it wouldn't be too difficult,
yeah,
right? Because the 1/2 times 12 is 6, we get a minus 6 there, positive times negative. And we're nearly there, right? We just need to get y by itself, which would mean we need to do what? We don't want to divide because there's nothing multiplied by
y. We want to add the 1.
Let's add the 1, right? Y minus, we think about it in a number line, we have y minus 1, that's where we are right now. We subtracted 1, that's y minus 1. So we'll add 1, right, to get just to y. Right? Right, so that's the idea there.
Now,
so add 1. Add 1. Y equals 1/2x minus 5. Okay, so we can definitely graph that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Slope of 1/2, so up 1 and over 2, like that, and grab it like that. Okay, so we can write it in slope-intercept form, grab it that way. But we could also say, remember this is the point-slope form, it's completely usable. This is the slope, right? And this x1 and y1, remember it comes from the slope equation, right? And so this x1 and y1 are just the x and the y of a point. X and the y of some point. Well, why not this point right here, 6, negative 2? Well, actually, we have this equation. So we have 12, right, 12 and 1, right? Making sure that it says minus, right, because the equation has a minus. So we know that there's this point on the graph at 12, right? Because it's minus 12, so the x is at positive 12. And 1, y is 1, because we have a minus 1 right here, and that's the way the equation is supposed to look. So 12, 1 is a point on the line. Let's scroll down. So if I came over here to 12, 1 and followed my slope of up 1 over 2, that would give me the line as well. It's either way really that you care to do it. But if it's already written like this, I can just throw it all onto the graph and graph away. I'm going to give you the rest of the time to work on a few problems yourself and ask questions.